Now, a lot of times there is a correct way to carry wallpaper, whether it's lining paper or whether it's normal standard wallpapers, what's folded in an envelope. We put it over his elbow. Now, you'll see this a lot better when we come to go up and down the walls with the finished papers. It goes across your arm folds, and it comes onto your chest. If you're going to walk into something, it's protected at all times. So that's how you carry wallpaper. It looks professional, it is professional. I will show you more when we come to the pattern papers. So that's as wallpaper carried. The one thing I didn't at this stage pick up with you is, I'm going to put this down, hopefully nobody's going to stand on it, so it's somewhere safe. We're going to want a damp cloth. Yeah? Now, it's so easy to walk to the sink every time, isn't it? And think, oh, I need a damp cloth. So off you go to the sink, back you come, off you go to the sink. It's so easy just to get a paint kettle. I like to put a little bit of soap in. I mean, it has got fungicidal in this in paste nowadays, modern stuff. I like to put a little bit of soap in there, purely and simply. I don't have to keep going to the sink. I can just wash my cloth out where I'm working, and everybody should be happy at that. Right, I've got a cloth, and again, I'm working at the top of the wall. Now, there's two things can happen here. I'm hoping that the way I'm going to show you now, everything's going to go all right. If you're going to struggle, we wouldn't use one pair of steps. We would use two. We'd put two pair of steps up. Remember, you want a bit of distance between the wall. It's no good having your steps there if you're going to struggle up against the wall. We want a little bit of distance away from that wall, so we've got comfort. If we wanted to do the ceiling, we would put a batting across or a plank across the two at the appropriate height. We're not going to do the ceiling today. We will do it at a later stage. Don't be frightened of ceilings. There's very little difference between the ceiling and the wall, and it's quite easy when you get to know the proper way of doing it. The other thing is the cloth. Most paper hangers have a wet shoulder. That's your reason. It's your cloth. Sometimes you'll see they've got like a waterproof part of shirt there. And that's why it is. It's for this cloth. If you're working on steps, you can always pop it on steps. But normally, that's the place it goes. I've got my scissors, and I've got my hanging brush. Right. My paper hanging brush, and the other thing I've got is a pencil. Just try and remember, we've sharpened both ends of the pencil. If it does break while I'm up there, I don't want to be coming down to sharpen my pencil. I'll just turn it round and keep going. Yeah, so that's as far as we've got with that. I'm going to pick my paper back up. I'm going to go up to the wall. First one's going across the top. It used to be at one time, people would mark out the 55 centimetres and they would put a chalk line across. My theory on this now is it's much easier for me to put a strip in at the bottom than it is at the top. So that's the way I'll work this one. And I'm going to work to what we've got. And you'll find on site that's 99.9% of how it happens. I'm going to go up my steps. I'm going to get to a comfortable height. If I'm not at a comfortable height, I can't work properly. I need to be able to feel and touch what I'm doing. I'm going to take my first piece off. Now, this is where you find a lot of people struggle. For the first piece, open two folds, no more. You're going to offer it up to the wall. So I've opened two pieces and I've offered it up to the wall. I've got a nice piece there. The reason I've got that piece there is because I'm going to cut it off. I don't want to be struggling when I come to cut it. Right, I've offered it up. The first thing I'm going to do with this brush is pull it straight across the middle to my hand. I'm then going to put it down. Yeah, done. Now, all I'm going to do is I'm going to take one fold at a time, and each time, straight down the middle and across. Now, if I fold this back like that and put my hand on it, you can see it should more or less, if I've mixed my paste properly, it should more or less stop up there, quite sufficiently long enough for me to move these steps along. I shouldn't have to rush. I should just be able to move my steps along if you've mixed your paste properly. Obviously, if you've mixed your paste too thin, it's going to be on floor, you've got problems. Or if you're going to struggle with that, put your batting across. All I'm going to do now, carry on from where I left off, one fold at a time. Why am I doing one fold at a time? I've got control. At all time when I'm doing this, I've got control. One fold means I've got control. If I've got two or three folds out, I've got a lot of paper to cover. If something goes wrong, I've got to start folding my paper back, trying to get back to where I've started. So each time, it should stop there, solid as a rock, plenty enough for me to keep moving. We're smoothing out any bubbles, any air bubbles, and any paste bubbles. Paste bubbles are very hard to work out. I've left one there, hard to see, but if you press it and it's squishy, it's a paste bubble. I'm not going to leave any air bubbles, because if you leave air bubbles, a paste bubble will dry out. An air bubble will not dry out. So, along the middle, outwards. When I get to the end, all I'm going to do, I'm going to take that back into the corner. I'm going to run down first with my finger. I'm going to get my pencil. Now, the important thing at this stage is with the pencil, if I'm cutting off that wall, I want to be marking on that wall. I don't mark this wall, I mark that wall. Same with principle on the ceiling when we come to the pattern papers. If I'm cutting off the ceiling, I will put the pencil line across the ceiling, not across the wall. Yeah, so the pencil line is going across the... So in this situation, I will angle the pencil down the wall and not as a lot of people do that way. All I'm going to do then, I'm going to pull it off the wall, remembering it's only ever going to cut to where I point that point. Yeah, these walls are very old, been painted a lot of times. I'm wanting to do it on areas like this because when you come to somebody's house, you will not get the perfect wall. Now, it's okay me, and I've seen it a lot now where people are just going on, they've got this perfectly straight, perfect wall. It doesn't happen in real life. You're going on somebody's house where they've got these horrible corners. Now, the important thing now, what we must remember, is this paste, what's on this wall, needs to come off. There's two things going to happen if we leave paste on something, and it never happens straight away. It's going to go yellow. If it doesn't go yellow, what's going to happen is somebody's going to paint over it. Now, paint is thicker than paste, so as the paint dries, the paste is weak and it'll flake off. So, 3 or 4 weeks after somebody's finished job, they get a phone call, oh, my ceiling's gone yellow, or, oh, paint's flaking off. Whereabouts? Outside at paper. It's down to paste. So we finish this side, we go back to us other side. Exactly the same principle. Finger down. Yeah. Make sure you're close enough to see what you're doing. You don't want to be a long way away from this. You want to be as close as you can get. Pencil down the edge. Same again. It's only ever going to go to where I point that point. So my concentration is on where I'm pointing the point of the scissors to. Right, the other thing is, we're going to look at something in a second which is slightly different. My paper, I'm just spending a minute at this stage, folding it up and putting it in my pouch. It's all right, we can throw it on the floor. It's very slippery. Somebody stands on it, they fall down, it's bad. We don't want to be looking for scissors all over. Put them in there, that you know where they are every time. You get used to it easy enough. These have got two pouches on. The amount of times people try and stick them in that one pouch, you don't go there. But that's the scissor pouch. Now, the only other problem you'll find with the new modern scissors is they have a sharp point. If you put them in there and you bend your leg, there's every chance that they're going to stick it back. So sometimes you'll see people have got like a tube, you know, in that pouch. That's the reason, because with the new scissors, if they bend the leg, it does tend to stick in and hurt. So, as first piece is up, the only other thing I want to show you about the scissors is as you've got your scissors, hold them up against the light. If you can see through that gap, they're no good. So you want to make sure that there's no light gap there, because that's your cutting edge. And as it cuts together, that's the edge you're cutting to. A quick wipe, make sure there's no paste on them, and you're off for your next piece.